Welcome back to the channel. Today we're gonna go over something very important, and that's kind of the concept of keeping your chin tucked. And this video idea comes from Blanco, and he asked us to do a video on keeping your chin tucked even when you attack the body. And today we're gonna go over that with our trusty tennis ball, which you've seen a bunch in our videos. And again, we're gonna use this tennis ball in a drill to keep our chin tuck. First drill. Oh, this, how many drills are you going to do? One? Do you have any drills?
One. Well, I don't have drills. I have suggestions though.
Okay, so one drill and suggestions.
Yes.
All right, guys. So for the drill in this video, we're going to use a tennis ball. And it's really, really simple. It's as easy as we're going to make it seem. It's literally putting the tennis ball under your chin and holding there. And of course, you have to use some force, some strength to keep it there, but it creates the habit of keeping your chin tucked when you're sparring or drilling. So I suggest that not when you're sparring, actually. You can't use it when you're sparring. Yeah. Don't use it when you're sparring, when you're drilling. So when you're hitting mitts, when you're hitting the bag, the heavy bag, double end bag, put this under your chin like so, and you're gonna look kind of weird, but I mean, it creates the habit of keeping your chin tucked. So what you want to do, even when you're shadow boxing, for example, we're going to shadow box right now. You do here, keeping your chin tucked, and you just do everything, you move around, you do everything you would do otherwise, just put this under your chin. It's literally that simple.
The only suggestions that I would actually have is when, let's say, like you're sparring or you're working with a partner, to actually put your punches over your chin itself, right? So, you know, try to keep your chin tucked a little bit, but also make sure that your punches, when you're throwing them, they're a little bit higher than usual. You don't want to get too exaggerated, like throwing punches way up here, but you know, you kind of want to keep your chin tucked. And when you kind of want to make sure that when you throw these punches, your chin is actually tucked under these shoulders. So that's probably one of the suggestions I would give you. So stay right here. And let's say, like from this angle, you can probably see a little bit better. If I throw my left cross, for example, like you see that my chin is like right under this deltoid right here. So what you want to do is always try to keep your chin under these shoulders. That's like a good guideline you could actually follow. So if you're throwing punches, keep it right here, keep it right here, keep it right here. Just make sure that every time you throw, make sure like almost as if your goal is for your shoulder to protect your chin. So what I would suggest every time you hit the body is the same thing that I would suggest if you were punching up here. When you go for the body, try to protect your chin with your shoulders every time you throw a punch. Actually change levels, actually use your feet to kind of squat down and throw some punches. You don't want to throw a body shot up here because of the fact that you're open for counters, right? And the fact that you're throwing right here pretty much leaves your chin exposed. You could get caught with a punch that could actually KO you or really hurt you in the fight. You're gonna squat down and cross, right? You guys don't want to leave your chin exposed, especially when throwing punches down there, because of the fact that you don't want to get countered, you don't want to get hurt, or you don't want to get knocked out. Another thing that I would actually suggest is don't try to punch too low. Even if your opposition is a little bit lower, don't try to punch too low. Like, make yourself a little bit smaller. Like, smaller. Yeah, like, don't try to punch too low, right? Because sometimes, especially these taller fighters, they go down low, right? They start punching down low. And let's say he, throws like a gazelle punch and decides to, out of nowhere, spring up and shoot. Like, I'm exposed. Something Tyson did a lot. So, coming in, just boom. Exactly. There we go. Tyson would set himself very low, wait for his opposition to throw a punch, and then out of nowhere, once he sees the opening that the punch was low, you know, he would come in, boom, like a leaping left hook, almost like Roy Jones. What you guys always want to do is try to stay leveled with your chin. I'm coming up here, throwing these shots right here. My chin is protected by my deltoid. If I go here, same thing, my shoulder's right there protecting my chin. If I go down low, same thing, I'm protecting the chin. Protecting the chin, always lined up. You guys don't want to be throwing too low because you guys could get hit with those springing shots, especially those big jumping looping shots. You guys kind of want to avoid all of that. You guys don't want to get hurt. So that's probably like a good suggestion that I would give you guys. And you guys could actually mix that suggestion and those tips with the drill itself. And so eventually you guys could actually end up protecting your chin a whole lot more, especially during sparring or fights themselves.
So that's gonna be it for today's video. Check out the links down below. We have a new Instagram account that we made. It's E1_combat. And also check out our personal pages down below, our website. Get these cool shirts, some cool sweaters. And that's about it. Thanks you guys for watching, and peace.